Is a man more likely to be promoted than a woman, even if they have the same qualifications? We'll consider an experiment investigating this question from the 1970s, where 48 male bank supervisors were asked whether they would recommend a particular candidate for promotion. Each supervisor was given a resume and determined whether the candidate should be promoted or not. Every one of these 48 resumes was identical, except that 24 were labeled as male candidates, and 24 were labeled as female candidates. Out of these 48 candidates, 35 were recommended for promotion, and 13 were not. If men were favored, we'd expect to see a higher fraction of promotions in the male group than in the female group. If there was no favoritism, then we would expect to see about the same promotion rate in each group. These two competing ideas are called hypotheses. The hypothesis of no difference is called the null hypothesis, and the other hypothesis is called the alternative hypothesis. Let's take a look at the data. What we see is that there were more men recommended for promotion than women, 7 more, or a difference of about 29% in promotion rates. So does this prove that women were discriminated against? No. No? But didn't we just determine that if men were favored, then we'd expect to see a higher fraction of men recommended for promotion than women? Well, yes, but observing some difference does not automatically mean there was discrimination. We wouldn't expect the recommendation rate in both the male and female groups to be exactly the same. There might be a difference from chance alone. So if anything can happen from randomness, how do we decide what to conclude from the data? This is a tough question, and it's one reason the study of statistics is so useful. In this experiment, we should ask, how often would I see data like this if there was no discrimination? That is, how uncommon would it be to see this large of a difference in the recommendation rates if there was no discrimination? This will help us think about whether the data are easily explained by chance, or whether we're seeing some strong evidence that there was discrimination. So now we have to figure out, what would a result look like that was from chance alone? We can answer that question by reassigning the resumes to the 48 supervisors, and assuming each banker's response would be the same as before. After all, if the bankers weren't affected by the gender of the candidate, their responses would be unchanged. And what's the result? We get a difference of 4% favoring men. This is smaller than the 29% difference we observed in the real data. But one simulation is not itself convincing. We want to know how variable the difference is from one sample to another. So let's run another simulation. This time we get 4% in favor of women. And another simulation, a 20% difference in favor of men. We'll run a total of 100 simulations and plot each simulation's result. Now as we look at the plot, we ask ourselves, how often do we see a difference at least as big as what we actually observed, which was 29%? In this case, pretty rarely. Only 2 of the 100 simulations showed this kind of result. So now we're left to think about 2 possibilities. We know that it's possible but very unlikely that, if there was no discrimination, we would observe a 29% difference from chance alone. Alternatively, the data are consistent with what we'd expect if there was discrimination against the female candidates. Because it's so unlikely to observe a gender promotion rate of 29% if there really was no gender discrimination, we reject H0 and conclude there was real gender discrimination. We've just covered what is called a hypothesis test, which is a formal approach for evaluating a research question. We analyzed the data, and we came up with a randomization approach to assess whether the difference we observed in the data could reasonably be explained by chance, and conclude there was real gender discrimination. Thanks for watching. If you've learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend, and visit openintro.org for more resources.